to you and happy Monday. Welcome to the Midday. I'm Melanie Lawson and this is your news update. First, an afternoon thunderstorm slamming into our area. This was one of our producers. They ran into a real roadblock while making his way into work this morning. This was on Bissonnette near Wesleyan in southwest Houston. There's a big shopping center there, you might remember. Well, check out the rain coming down in Cinco Ranch. Now, this is off of FM 1093 and Spring Green Boulevard, again, in Cinco Ranch. You can see the water ponding pretty good there. And ABC 13's Nick Notario shot this video this morning. Storms moving through the Richmond area. You can see there was a lot of rain, a lot of lightning. Thankfully, though, no serious flooding. That's the good bit of news. And Rachel, we've seen a lot of rain come down, but it seems to be moving through pretty quickly.
Yeah, it's making its way off to the east, and that's what we're going to see as we push throughout the rest of this afternoon. It's going to slowly but surely move off to the east, affecting some of our southern areas too. So if you have not seen this rainfall yet and you are to the east of this line of storms, you could see it as we head into the afternoon hours. So let's break down what you can expect on Future Track. This is showing you at around 1 p.m. So it is rather slow moving. That's why we are dealing with the potential for that isolated flooding. Needless to say, this is going to hold on to that threat for heavy rainfall and also the threat for a lot of lightning. So this is still going to be dangerous as it pushes off to the east. Now, eventually heading into, I would say, mid to late afternoon, we should start to see it push off of the coast. Now, the biggest question, will we see redevelopment behind this line? I would say there is still that chance. Now, do I think it's going to be as big of a line as what we saw this morning? No, I think that is really going to have been our main show, but some isolated to some scattered activity cannot be ruled out heading into the afternoon. So if you do any outdoor plans this afternoon, make sure you check your radar before you end up heading on out, and you can actually find that radar in abc13.com. So that's what we are expecting throughout the rest of this afternoon. Into the evening, could see some lingering rain, but everything should become very isolated as we head into the overnight hours. And then heading into Tuesday, another round of that rainfall could roll on in, could actually look kind of similar to today with that line pushing in along a boundary as we head into the morning hours. That's going to continue to push off to the east. And this model is actually showing redevelopment on Tuesday night, another line pushing on in. And the problem with the next few days is we actually have a ton of moisture to work with. So any shower or storm that we get is going to drop some very heavy rainfall, and it could drop it very quickly. So that could cause some street flooding issues. That's really going to be our main concern for this week. Now, in terms of severe weather this week, our chances are on the low end. Are they zero? No, we actually have a chance to see an isolated severe storm or two as we head into this afternoon, as well as into Tuesday and Wednesday. Now, if we do happen to see a severe storm, I would say the main threat most likely going to be the threat for some gusty winds up to 60 miles per hour, although some large hail, some isolated large hail, cannot be completely ruled out. In terms of the tornado threat, it will be on the low end, but it is not zero. But again, main focus will be on the threat for that heavy rainfall. You can see potential rain for the next 7 days right here. You can see that big swath over towards Houston, stretching up towards Livingston and down towards the coast. So in some areas already today, we have seen 3 inches, even over 3 inches. So by the time this whole rain event ends, by the end of the work week, some of us could have seen over 5 to even 6 inches of rain. So we are going to be talking some very heavy rainfall as we head throughout the rest of this week. You can see rain chances going to continue and go up as we head into midweek. Mel.
All right. Thanks so much, Rachel. Well, all businesses in Harris County must enforce a no mask, no service policy starting today. Judge Lena Hidalgo signed the order designed to slow the spread of COVID-19. Which is going back up in our area. It requires employees and customers who are at least 10 years old to wear a mask.
Actually, until I walked in here, I was totally against it. But now I'm thinking, what's the big deal? I'll wear one.
I totally agree with it. I'm from the East Coast, and there's a lot of my friends lost their parents and stuff. So I get it. So, I mean, sometimes it's hard for us to breathe and work, but it's totally like, you know, it makes sense.
Yeah, well, right now, Harris County Judge Lena Hidalgo says individuals will not be fined, but businesses can be if they don't enforce the mask order with their customers. And check this out, the fine can be up to $1,000. Well, no arrest in that deadly shooting rampage during a Juneteenth celebration in Charlotte. 2 people were killed, 12 others were hurt, and some of the injured were run over by drivers trying to get away from the scene. A very dangerous situation in New Jersey. A man man climbed to the top of this amusement park ride, can you believe it, and put up an American flag. Local police say this was a protest against a neighboring law enforcement agency. He has since climbed down, and no surprise here, he is now resting comfortably behind bars. And watch this video out of West Texas. Wow, a police officer ran into a home that had been ripped apart by strong winds. Look at that. He pulled a woman out of the rubble, and as he carried her out, the rest of the home came crashing down. No, this is not a movie. This actually happened. He was able to get her out unharmed. Amazingly enough, just as that house literally was torn apart by the high winds. And some of Disney World's resort hotels are reopening today. Masks will be required for guests 2 and older. Magic Kingdom and Animal Kingdom will both reopen, but not in time for the hotels, the resorts. They do not open until July the 11th. And that's going to do it for the midday for now. I'm Melanie Lawson. You can check out our weather all day long on abc13.com. Have a great Monday.